Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to talk about a correlation feature in JMeter. So let us understand what is correlation. That's the first thing, and then we'll see why the correlation is required. And also, I'm going to discuss about how to use regular expression extractor along with the correlation. So first of all, let us see what is correlation. So correlation is the process of extracting some value from the response of a step and referring it into the request of another subsequent step is called as a correlation. So here basically there is one request, and when I send some request, it will give you some response. I need to get some value from that particular response, and I'll use the same value into the next subsequent request. So that's called as a correlation. So here referencing is done at the runtime dynamically. So it is also called as dynamic reference. So for example, here, step one, we need to do extract dynamic value from the response of step one, and the same value we need to refer or extracted the we need to refer the extracted value in the request of the next request of the subsequent step. So that is a basically concept of correlation. So to achieve this correlation, so exactly where the correlation is required. So sometimes in your test there may be a need to refer values from earlier steps which cannot be determined prior to test execution, as these are generated at the runtime. So for example, here I have a test plan, so which contains a number of test scenarios like login, home page, and logout. Every scenario have some requests and get some responses, right? Suppose every sessions or every request, there will be session ID will be created, and this session ID will be created at the runtime dynamically. So we don't have any control on this, but still I want to use the same session ID in the next request or next subsequent request. So this is exactly a scenario where we can use correlation concept. Now here we can achieve the correlation in these different steps. So here I'm also going to use regular expression extractor to achieve the correlation concept. So as part of this, what I can do is, first of all, as a step one, I'll create a test plan where you want to do dynamic referencing in JMeter. So let's do the step one. So go to your JMeter. So here currently I have a test plan. So I'm also adding some thread group. So now currently I have a test plan. I have a thread group. So let me save this test plan as, let's say, correlation one and dot JMX and save it. Okay, now I have saved my plan. So I have one thread group. So that's step one, create a test plan where you want to do dynamic referencing in JMeter. And step two, I will also add, in this thread, I'm also adding some sampler. Let's say I'm adding HTTP request. So under this HTTP request, so I will just specify, this is, let's say, HTTP request one. So when I run, when I send this request, I will get the response. From that particular response, I'll extract some value, which is dynamically generated. So in HTTP request, so what I will do is I will just do the request to this particular website. So if you just go to this particular website, so here this particular website is having some links are available. So this is basically home page, and if you click on the home page here, go to the home, and it will display some login and register features. Okay, so I'm just going to use this particular URL, and /login is a path. So here in HTTP request, so I'll provide the URL, and under path, I will just say login. So this will perform request to the login page of this particular application. All right, so this is simple HTTP request I have done. So let's save this one. And after that, I will also add one listener. So go to plan, and I'll just add one listener. Let's say view results tree. So now I have added also view results tree listener. So when I run this request, let me clear everything. And when I save it and run the request, so HTTP request one will hit the server. And then if you come to the view results tree, so my request is executed. And this is the exact request went to server, and here response data. So this is the response data, we got it. So now what I can do is in this particular response data, I need to check whether registration link is are there. So first of all, I need to check how many links are there in this page. And then finally, I need to go and use this particular link, register, okay? So what I will do is I'm just copying this response, and there is a website where we can verify the regular expressions, or we can generate our regular expression. So here, what is my intention is, from this particular response, I will capture some value. Okay, so that is a register link URL. I'll capture dynamically from this particular response, and that particular URL I will pass to the next request. Okay, so to capture this value from this response, I'm just creating another post processor, because after this request I need to capture that value, right? So after this request I need to execute post processor request. So right click on this thread group and go to add post processors. Under this I'm just selecting regular expression extractor. So let me just take this one. So regular expression extractor, so what this will do is, it is applicable for now main sample, and here name of the name of created variable, expression template, match number, default value. So this section is very important for us. So here we need to specify the name of the created variable. So I'm just giving some variable here. Let us say my variable name is, I'm just giving, okay, so register link. So this is my variable name, and here what I should do is, I just say for now I need to provide the regular expression here. So here, just go to view results key, whatever response we got it from the request one, and we need to capture the response in the result. In the response data, copy the response data, and here there is a website that is regexpression, EXR, okay, so EXR, regexr.com. So this is a basically a website where we can generate our XPaths. So let it open. So here, suppose we can write some text here, and here we can write the XPath, and we can check whether this XPath is matching a proper pattern or not. We can verify that. So here I'm just copying the response, whatever I have got from my first request, right? So here I will write one expression. So what I want to do here is, from this particular response, there are some register link, login link, right? So somewhere. So I want to capture the link of the register. So if I see here, so here it is. Okay, so I want to capture this particular value, right? So how we can do this? I need to write a regular expression here, which will exactly identify this one. So here actually it is starting from anchor tag href is equal to some link is there. This is the URL of the link and register, right? So here I'm writing a regular expression. So let's see how we can write. So it'll say slash a, right? So when I say slash a, it can also use list here, and this will give you what all matchings are there. When I say less than a, this is a tag name. So currently there are four tags are there with this one. So means there are four links are there. And again, I'm just continuing href. So I'll say href, and again press enter. Now with this particular value, there are two lines of code is available, or there are two lines of code exist in this HTML. Now again, I'll just extend it. Href is equal to, okay, href is equal to, and here double quotation start, and here actual value is there. This is the actual string is available here, right? And after, suppose let's say for now, I'm just saying say XXXXX something. And after that, I'm closing the bracket. So when I run this with this hard coded value, we don't have anything. There are no results. Now what I can do is, here under href, we can have any URL. So because href tag, anchor tag is there. So let's say 3 to 4 tags are available in this particular page, right? So here I will write a small regular expression like this. So in here, I can have any link. I'll say bracket dot star. So what this is exactly representing is, so the first one is common there. So commonly it is matched. And here dot star means it can be any URL, and I have grouped together, because later I will extract only this particular URL from this regular expression. So if you see this particular regular expression, which is exactly matching with two things. Okay, so we need again second one, not the first one, right? So if you click on the list, it is listed out two things. So this particular regular expression is exactly matching two URLs, right? So remember this. Now I'm using this regular expression. I'm using this regular expression inside my JMeter regular expression extractor. So registration link, and this is my regular expression. So what this regular expression will do, this will return two matches. And in these matches, again, I need to capture this one, not the first one. So template we have to use here. So template means we can specify the group number. For example, here currently only one group. So if you have multiple brackets, every bracket is comes under one group. So here, whichever bracket I specify here, whichever value here, I want to extract that value. So I need to refer this with some number. So number will start from one. So that is specified by using dollar symbol. Okay. So this will match two lines or two links among them. So especially this particular link I'm referring with this particular template. Okay. With this particular template is referring to group. So here this link is exactly pointing to this group, because when I say bracket, that is called as a group. So here I'm referring that. If you have multiple groups, you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, something like that. Okay, you can refer each group with number. All right. All right, so now template value have specified, and here we need to say match number. So which one we need to select? Second one, because I need to open the registration page. So match is two. So once we specified this one, so then save it again. So we have created a regular expression extractor. So where we have to create after sending the first request, right? So then we need to create the regular expression extractor. So this will execute after completion of the first request, because this is a post processor request. So this will be executed after completion of the first request. And on that particular request, we got some response. From that particular response, using this regular expression, it will capture the registration value. Now this variable I will refer in the next request. So here I'm going to create one more HTTP request. So after this post processor, I'm creating one more HTTP request. Let's say to here. I don't provide any URLs now. Directly, whatever variable I have captured this value, the same variable I am referring inside the path. And how to refer this? We need to put that into curly braces. And then we need to use dollar symbol at the beginning. So this is how we need to refer the variables in JMeter. All right, so now the save it. So the first request will send this request, login page will open. From there, regular expression extractor will extract that values, registration links, or whatever links are there in that page, all the links will be extracted by using this regular expression. And again, you say template value. So template means the group, that is exactly group value, that is link will be extracted. And there are two links are there, so I need to refer exactly second link. So if you notice this particular page, so you will clearly understand. So these are two things are written, two URLs are written. So the second one I need. So that's the reason I say match number two. And group is nothing but this particular portion. So whichever bracket we provided, that is called as a group. So that value I'm extracting into this particular one. Okay, fine. So now I created regular expression extractor, then created HTTP request, and this will use the variable which is created in regular expression extractor. So what we have done so far is request one, send the request to the server, we'll get the response. From that response, it will extract that value, that is registration link. And the same value, again, I'm using as a parameter to the request two, as an input to the request two. Here I'm referring the variable. And then we'll see the results. So let me save everything, and I'm cleaning the results, and let's execute the plan now. So run this. Now you can just observe the view results tree. Now the first request is executed. Now the second request is also executed. So now you see here in the first request one, what is the request it is sent? This is a login page, right? This request is representing the login. So it is also giving some response data. Now in the request two, if you go to the request two, it is using register link, because this is captured from response data which is sent by the first request. Okay, but in the second request, we haven't specified anything here. We have captured this value from the previous request and previous request response, right? From the response from the first request. So the same value I'm referring here. So this is exactly the concept of correlation. So here to achieve the correlation, I have just used regular expression extractor. This is basically post processor method or post processor request. So this will execute always after completion of the request. And here most important thing is the regular expression we need to know how to write the regular expression to capture the specific value from the response. That we need to understand here. That's the most important thing. All right. So this is how we need to use a correlation in JMeter. And here the main important another tip is also there. Suppose if you want to check the regular expression is correct or not, and there is another option is available here under view results. Suppose let me capture this regular expression and go to view results tree. And here you can now you have one more option called regex tester. So here I've selected first request. And here if you go to response data, it is a response, right? And here what I can do is I'm just check my XPath is right or not. So regex right or not, select regex tester. Now in the first request response, I'm just providing the this is a regular expression. So this is a response from first request and this is an XPath. Now if you click on the test here, so it is exactly matching with the two links. This is the first link, this is the first link and this is the second link. So that's the reason I specified the two here. So two is the index number I specified. Okay. So this is another tip where we can check whether our XPath is our regular expression is exactly matching those links or not. Okay. So that's all about the correlation in JMeter by using regular expression extractor as a post processor request. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.